Hello everybody, and a very warm welcome to LMT YouTube channel.
I'm sorry, we haven't met.
We have. I was in costume at the time. Sarah Spencer's younger sister.
The mad tree.
Diana.
Who is the Crown's Princess Diana, Emma Corrin. When Netflix released the highly anticipated fourth season of The Crown, November 2020, fans of the series were on the edge of their seats, more than ready to finally see Princess Diana's story. Of course, finding the perfect actress to play the people's princess was surely no easy feat, but the show found a winner in Emma Corrin. Like Princess Diana, Corrin had a humble beginning and actually worked in retail just 2 years before nabbing the role of Princess Diana. Since The Crown is Corrin's breakthrough role, she has been thrusted into the public eye much like Lady Diana Spencer, who was a part-time kindergarten teacher before she married the future King of England, Prince Charles. While we won't give away any details of the couple's tumultuous relationship that viewers will see play out in the series, Corrin used the struggles of her newfound fame to channel her inner Dynasty Diana. Corrin told Variety, recalling a conversation with The Crown director Benjamin Caron. Ben said, "To me, if you ever get followed by a photographer, or your name ends up in the paper, when you're surrounded by flashing lights, and you feel daunted, or overwhelmed, or anything you feel, this is exactly how she would be feeling. You're going to have a parallel experience. The show already has changed my life quite a lot, and I expect when it comes out, things will get a little mad for a bit." Emma Corrin grew up aspiring to be like Princess Diana. As a British who was raised in the post-Princess Diana era, Emma Corrin idolized the beloved royal. The actress said, "I grew up very aware of her being generous and empathetic, a people person, and how rare that was. Whenever I heard about her with someone or watch a documentary, I remember thinking, oh, this is the kind of person who I want to be, which is now weird." She told LMT Channel with a laugh, adding, "I went a little too far. Since, as of this writing, the fourth season marks the most modern era The Crown has covered thus far, the pressure was on to do the role justice." Director Benjamin Caron said, "Normally we don't go to someone who is almost a lookalike. We find the best actor, but she had both, and that felt a little bit unnerving." With the strength Princess Diana had to deal with her tumultuous marriage and her inner demons, specifically her battle with bulimia, Corrin had to walk the line between strength and vulnerability. Caron said, "Everyone struggles with tough love, no one more so than Diana, and Emma captured that aspect of the human condition, that desperate intensity of youth when everything feels all or nothing." He added, "Viewers will come to this season with a picture of Diana in their minds. I know I did. But Emma's performance is so compelling, she will very quickly win people over as the Crown's Diana. Why you didn't see Charles and Diana's wedding in The Crown?" Season 4 of The Crown is finally on Netflix, which means the Princess Diana era has arrived. And you better believe the show recreated some of her fashion moments, including her elaborate wedding dress. However, The Crown didn't show any part of the actual wedding. All the viewers got was a shot of Emma Corrin, who plays the late Princess of Wales, walking into the ceremony with a super long train behind her. Excluding the wedding threw off some fans, with one person tweeting, "I even repeated the same episode as I thought I missed the wedding. Where is the freaking wedding?" Someone else remarked, "They really built up the wedding and the trailers to only show us the back of the dress for a few seconds." A different fan shared similar sentiments, tweeting, "I can't believe I patiently awaited The Crown to see all the pomp and pageantry for Princess Diana's wedding, and them get and show a 15-second back view of the dress." Another viewer observed, "They really spent 600 hours replicating that wedding dress, and for what? I feel cheated given the build-up in the trailers." On the flip side, some fans are more than fine with this move. One person admitted, "I, for one, am glad The Crown doesn't show the royal wedding. We lived that for months in the 80 seconds. And it's the least interesting part of the story. Why was such a major moment in royal history excluded from the show?" There's a simple explanation for it. The Crown only reenacts moments that further the plot. Emma Corrin said, We never recreate things just for the sake of recreating them. I think if we do recreate a scene, like the engagement scene, for instance, when they do the announcement, it has to be because it's linked to something that the characters are going through. It has to be part of the story. Summing it up, The Crown will only reenact moments the world has already seen if it will further the plot. Corrin went on to note that anyone who wants to revisit the actual wedding can YouTube it, so she does not see any point in us recreating it. Josh O'Connor, who plays Prince Charles on The Crown, added, "That's why The Crown is so good. Series creator Peter Morgan isn't interested in showing you the wedding because, yeah, Emma's right. You just go on YouTube and you can watch it." Additionally, the actor acknowledged that there is more license to create and fictionalize in a scene that people haven't seen before, which makes sense. Even so, it is logical to show certain well-documented events in order to show viewers this is where we are instead of straight up telling them by posting dates or captions on screen. O'Connor explained that Morgan basically signposts the show's timeline using historical events, like the engagement interview or the lead into the wedding. All roads lead back to Queen Elizabeth on The Crown. Even though many of The Crown fans wanted to see Prince Charles and Princess Diana exchange their vows on the show, it does detract from the show's central focus, Queen Elizabeth II. Emma Corrin said, "They don't follow any plot lines that don't directly link to The Crown, which is really interesting." She explained that The Crown's creator Peter Morgan wants every storyline on the series to feed back to the Queen, so the show is not going to cover everything that happened in the royal family at that time. Corrin said, "Even Diana's plotline, it's all about what she's doing and the effect that that's having on the Queen. That's why it's called The Crown. That is logical, but as Netflix shared on Twitter, it took a lot of time and effort to replicate Princess Diana's wedding dress, only for a super quick shot of Corrin walking into the church." The actor revealed, "It took so many fittings just to make it, which was an experience. I'm so bad at fittings. I think everyone hated me by the end." She also said, "The experience of watching the dress come to life was very magical," adding that it kind of felt like Cinderella when they're waving the wand and she's being turned into this incredible princess, which is why so many viewers wanted to see the dress get more screen time. Nevertheless, it makes sense why the wedding was excluded.
Another analysis.
Princess Diana would have been rather jealous of both Kate Middleton and Meghan Markle. Princess Diana passed away in 1997 when her two sons, Prince William and Prince Harry, were children. As such, when the princes got married as adults, many royal followers wondered what Diana would have thought about their wives had she still been around. According to a friend of Diana's, the late princess would have actually been rather jealous of her sons' wives. Do Kate Middleton and Meghan Markle have a lot in common with Diana? First off, there have been a lot of questions about how much the prince's wives have in common with Diana. Catherine, Duchess of Cambridge, who married William in 2011, is often said to have elegance and grace like her mother-in-law. The two women also came from upper-class backgrounds. Diana was an aristocrat, and although Kate is usually thought of as a commoner, she had wealthy parents and attended prestigious schools. Meanwhile, Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, who married Harry in 2018, have been compared to Diana in her humanitarian work and outspoken nature. Diana rebelled against the royal family, and Meghan also did not hesitate to show her disapproval for the royal family's traditional ways. Why a friend says Princess Diana would have been rather jealous of Kate Middleton and Meghan Markle. Some people think Diana would have been able to get along with both Kate and Meghan. However, Diana's friend Tina Brown thinks the late princess would have been rather jealous of the two duchesses. Brown said, "Diana was very complicated and loved her boys to death and probably would have been rather jealous of both their wives." Of course, if Diana was still alive, a lot of things might be different in the royal family. As such, it's difficult to know for sure how her relationship with Kate and Meghan could have played out. Princess Diana wanted her sons to marry people they love. In any case, Diana might have been happy just to see her sons marry for love. Diana's own marriage to Prince Charles was a volatile one because her husband was in love with somebody else. Based on what she said when she was alive, it was clear Diana did not want William and Harry to go down a similar path. After Charles chose to go public with his affair in the 1990s, Diana wanted her sons to realize how important it is to find someone they love and hold on to them. She said in an interview with BBC's Panorama in 1995, "I went to the school and put it to William, particularly that if you find someone you love in life, you must hang on to it and look after it. And if you were lucky enough to find someone who loved you, then one must protect it." Both William and Harry ended up marrying women they love, and it seems Diana would have been happy to see that they did listen to her advice.
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one. Stop.